Can you walk through like the different types of dilutive securities and how they affect fully diluted share count?
Yes. So one of the most common diluted securities is stock options. Another one is, warrants. Warrants which be exercised. I believe there may, I'm sure there are additional, but those are the two primary forms which dilute ownership. If they're exercised after they hit the required strike price, and then minimize beginning with the treasury stock method if the company uses that upon receiving the proceeds from the employees exercising their stock options.
Okay, what else? There's more.
Okay, stock options, warrants. That dilute. Okay. Convertible.
Okay.
Convertible,
How do
which
you
is a, yes, which are forms of debt that offer, if I'm correct, forms of interest payment that may be exercised and converted into equity from the debt holders.
Okay.
Okay, so we got options, warrants, convertibles, and
Do you use treasury stock with convertibles?
what's the question?
Would you use the treasury stock method with convertible debt?
No, because those are not securities that the company is able to actually receive any proceeds from. It's more of an exercise right that the owner has that they may exercise.
Okay. What else? Anything else?
Those are the primary types of securities that I'm most interested in. Of course, there are more maybe exotic forms of securities.
What about RSUs?
Yes, RSUs, restricted stock units. I believe they are also a form of compensation to maybe senior level executives after a certain amount of time is either invested or a certain company-wide targets in terms of performance are met.
I wouldn't necessarily say it's only for senior executives. I think people can get them even if they're not that senior, but it's supposed to, I mean, both stock options and RSUs are supposed to be just like another form of employee compensation. But I think the difference between stock options and RSUs is that stock options are typically used by earlier stage companies, because like back when you were still like, say you're still like a small private company startup, like it doesn't, like your shares aren't even publicly traded. Like, okay, I can give you restricted stock, but like that might not really even have any value, right? Versus stock options is like give you the option to buy these shares at a predetermined price, and it's just an optionality that you have. So if the company doesn't do well, like you don't have to exercise the option and you just don't buy the shares, right? So earlier stage companies tend to use stock options, and then like once they get beyond a certain point and they are like big enough, or a lot of times like once they become public or they're getting close to going public, and there's like a better there's a better sense for like how much your shares are actually worth, then it can start just like giving you the shares straight up, right? Because you know, like if you work at Google and they give you know, 100 Google shares a year, like you can somewhat quantify how much 100 shares of Google is worth, right? Does that make sense?
So the so you said the RSUs are for more mature companies.
Relative to stock options, yes.
Okay, relative. Okay. Got it.
And the difference from a dilution standpoint is that RSUs, you also wouldn't do a treasury stock, right? Because there's no like exercise price. You don't have to like pay the company to get the shares. literally just become common shares. So it's just like it vests over time. It's restricted as in like, I can give you 240 shares and I can say this vests over the next 12 months. So you're getting 20 new shares a month, essentially.
Okay.
Does that make sense?
Yes. Mm-hmm.
And so like in an acquisition, a lot of these diluted securities will be in the money. And if they're in the money, then obviously they'll convert into additional shares. So then mm-hmm. that'll increase the equity value, which will increase the price of the acquisition. So that's the significance of these diluted securities. Does that make sense?
Mm-hmm.
Hey there, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you're looking for more customized advice that's tailored for your specific situation, then I invite you to book a free strategy session with our team at the link below. We'll talk to you soon.